In this evening's fight, Kraus is younger, taller, and has a longer reach than Kawi. But that advantage in reach is only relevant if they fight at a distance. And his greater fight could even be a disadvantage if Kawi crouches low, as he surely will, and Kraus might just have to punch down, which obviously is less effective. Kraus weighed in at 82.6. And Kawi at 85.8 for a slight advantage. And the South African and world champion, a man physically and mentally so much stronger than when he suddenly achieved international recognition. A lot more confident. And the crowd love his modesty. He's won so many friends over the last year. His statistics are a shade better than Kawi's. Kawi has more varied international background. He's been hardened by what life has done to him. But Kraus is the champion with two fine wins over Ricasio and then Stevens. The crowd has had a magnificent evening of boxing to warm them up in every sense of the word. And it would really make their evening complete. The Southern African crowd, if Pete Kraus could go through to another title defense. And it's a fight as unpredictable as a world title fight could be in any field, because they don't know Kawi quite so well. Kawi really has battled over the last couple of years to win a fight inside the distance. Kraus must be aware of this. Kraus, an athletic figure of a man. He's durable. And Bert Brewer beside me is going to take us through the fight. It should be a magnificent encounter.
As will be. Ingredients to be one of the great junior heavyweight fights since the division was first established in 1982. Kraus unbeaten. Never knocked out, got knocked twice. First by Ivy Brown and by Randy Stevens. Both times he came off the canvas to win. Kawi, a former WBC light heavyweight champion, lost the title in a unification title bout with Michael Spinks in March 1983. Then moved up to the junior heavyweight division. Unbeaten as a junior heavyweight, but really also unproven. He hasn't scored a knockout in the last 2.5 years. Was most unimpressive in his last two fights in this division. And rocketed to number one in the ratings. And Kraus makes his first mandatory defense against the American who, many years ago, knocked out Tennis Cock in Durban in 10 rounds.
Mr. Tony Naidoo will announce the details of the fight. The referee, by the way, Enzo Montero Moran from Venezuela. The judges will be the referee, also Samuel Conde Lopez from Paraguay, and Ryoji Kashiwagi from Japan. The fight will be supervised by a former WBA specialist, Dr. Elias Cordova.
Thank you, Mr. President. And ladies and gentlemen, let's give Sun International a very big hand for speaking to Mark Solomon. Let's give Sun International a very, very big hand. Thank you. And now, ladies and gentlemen, the main mark of the Sun International promotion is to the humiliation. Junior heavyweight world title over 15 rounds. The principles are on my left, wearing black and white, with a professional record of 26 fights and 2 defeats at 85.89 kilograms, the challenger from New Jersey, United States of America, Good Muhammad Darwin. As in the opposite corner, Ray White, with a professional record of 25 undefeated fights at 82.60 kilograms, runs around here, the champion of the world,
mounts this WBA title fight over 15 rounds, and the last few moments trickle away before they go into action. Round one, and straight away it's Poirier who goes to the body and the head. As expected, these first few rounds are going to be critical for the world champion. Kobe is a pressure fighter. He will take the action to grass, and he hopes to stop the defending champion before round six starts. Grass is boxing using the jab, and that's the strategy he needs to do. But he also needs to pick up his punch rate. Much too slow at the moment. Still, the fight's scheduled for 15. And the men will need to pace themselves. And it's Kraus scoring almost at will with that jab. If he hits it in Kwai's face long enough and often enough, he could well survive these critical first 5 rounds. The champion mixes up the right with the left. And that surge that we expected from Kobe hasn't materialized yet. The jab is bothering him. And now the American opens up. But it's slow punches, ponderous punches. A good right to the head. Swivel houses here. But the champion took it well. Gradually, slowly, Kraus putting more power behind his punches. Oh, look at those right hands from Kobe. Pitching Kraus back against the ropes. Stoppikin needs to move, to use lateral movement, more mobility. Standing almost still. He's taken those shots well. And that must disappoint the American. So the Americans were shocked. Randy Stevens got Kraus in there. Last fight in the Super Bowl. Well, we aim to do the same thing tonight. If he can. Round one coming to a close. And Kraus's left jab, which is almost in Kobe's face throughout the round, which is the round on point. It's
slow start. Most of the actors in here.
Grass, Spectre.
And some big punching from Cowley.
Some of the action was
relatively
what he can do.
It's the
Cross one round, one and a half card, almost down to felt as he kept his left jab in Corey's face. Almost the entire 3 minutes. I reckon showing a bit more activity at the start of round two. He came here with a reputation of being a pressure fighter, but we haven't seen very much of that so far. But this is early in the fight, and those punches certainly hurt Cross. Left and right to the head. Cross must not throw punches with Corey. The pride of a champion will dictate how he fights this fight. Krauss must not get overconfident. And surprisingly, there's very little mobility from the South African. Perhaps he's. Oh, that's a vicious right from Braxton. Quarry and another. Krauss appears to have little defense against those rights to the head. Quarry keeps coming forward, taking everything Krauss can throw, almost with contempt, as he throws those rights to the head. You can see his game plan. He needs to take Krauss out with shots to the head. And he needs to do it within 5 rounds. That jab is scoring points. This one's really hurting the other end. I guess Eddie probably could take that all night long. Bishop punches on fire. A little shook cross. And the American pulls his tongue in contempt. Still working with the jab. Champion's right hand's not getting through. While we take him off the cross, as he keeps moving forward, slowly but surely, around almost at an end. Only a matter of seconds to go.
Howie's corner, very satisfied with the match, which goes right to the head. Krauss has taken the well, but Krauss has certainly taken the punishment. There's one now. Another view of the action in round two.
Well, that's the best looking jab we've seen from Howie so far. And he appears to be business at the start of round three. Cup champions punches on not getting through that double team of guard at home, but that one had a very good run here in the final again. Oh, he's got this very awkward defense. Difficult to penetrate. Now's got through with a run of the gut between the gloves. And he keeps the left hand popping out. For a little finish from Cowie. He just keeps rolling forward. He thinks he's got punching range. And then firing those shots to the head. Like that. I think about it. The one was a bit low.
Yeah, coming two and three shots tonight. There's a there, though.
Notice the men are fighting mainly at close quarters. That's a surprise because everyone thought Kraus would fight from a distance. I guess he's got a little option. If he wants to get within punching range, he's got to close the gap. And mostly he's having to punch downwards at point. Very good right hand from Kraus. Kraus took it well. But how many of those punches can he take before they can get to that? We've seen Kraus come off the floor and win fights against Randy Stevens, Harvey Brown. That's a hard way to win a fight. American seems to be able to score the right hand almost at will. Going over the top of Kraus's left jab. 30 seconds left in this round. Action is picked up with a better punch rate from both men.
Moet verloor, dat Goedman vastweet. Waarom drie woorden nog even van Goedman?
Kom nu. Kijk.
Vastweet. Een keer dat je slaan, je moet van lijn slaan en vanaf slaan. Van nijn en vanaf staan, hoor. Die korter wil je om hard maken. Die onder, niet maak staan, moet je zwaar staan. Awesome, please.
There's the call.
Van nijn van nijn slaan.
Hoor. Hold on tight.
We doen daar de rest van. Dus allemaal voor de kom. Rob Smith wat nodig is, beweeg ze. En relax wanneer je die kans krijgt. Je is ver, ver voor met pakken. Die nodig van de kans.
Is the kans.
Well, the Kraus corner seem to think that the champion is far, far ahead on points, but not on our card. We've got the fight even as the men go into round four. And the question is just how much or how many of those right hands can Kraus take? Kraus is scoring well with a left jab. They certainly score points, but they don't appear to move the American. Although they do break Kari's rhythm. Oh, he was here for his fight with Tennis Croc. We saw that his punches are of the slow poison variety. They take time to really have an effect on our opponent. It took all of 10 rounds to knock out Tennis Croc. But those fighting right to the head will certainly tell against Kraus as the fight wears on. Now, Kraus is beginning to show a little mobility. And up on his toes, the boss is coming out again, but still getting caught with that right hand. He's scoring well with the jab. Kraus's defense, almost negligible. Almost non-existent. It's a good uppercut from Kraus. He didn't quite get it. Graze the American's face. There's a solid jab. He's sitting in it. Good body shot. With a good right hand from Kraus. The Americans tried to intimidate the champion. But before the fight, it was started round one. Kraus simply shrugged it off. Now the challenger is working the body. The Kraus goes to the head. Very good attack from Kraus and the bell there.
Kraus, yeah? Any new Arabic school is for the right?
Let's check out the other army's corner. Very quiet corner. That sounds a confident corner. Rouse's corner. Round four. As though Kraus means business for start of round five. The jab is working smoothly. The right hand is scoring. And Kraus is still pressing forward. That's his style. He'll keep coming. No need for Kraus to go and looking for the challenger. He's in front of him all the time. Kraus looking far, far better at this round. That was a good body shot.
That was it!
Kraus
is hot. Right
there, I can beat! There's a low punch from Kraus.
Right there, I can
beat! And another.
Give it to him underneath.
Edwin Moran on the side.
Give it to him!
Kraus beating the American to the jab.
That's it! That's it! Slow down! Slow down!
Now it's Kraus who's pinned in the corner. And, well, he misses the opportunity. Left and right went over the top of Kraus's head. Kraus is beating Kraus to the punch. That was quite significant. It could make all the difference between victory and defeat. Trouble. And the American knows it. imagine the opportunity he's got by.
Let's go! Awesome, 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 awesome.
Taking some very solid shots. Taking them well. But for how long? Right hand from cross. As Bowie actually leaned into the punch. Then he leans into just about every punch. Cross throws.
Let's go, let's go!
A good round for the challenger, Bowie. Great punch by Harvey. That one really hurt Kraus. One third of the way through the fight, and Harvey had a magnificent round. But the previous one, very much Kraus. Five rounds gone, and they were supposed to be five critical rounds for Pete Kraus, but he's still there. Still boxing from behind his jab. Certainly taking some very solid punches from Kwame.
Stay in your rhythm, Kwame.
Taking them well.
Stay in your rhythm. That's it. All right, let's go.
And for the first time, referee Moran walks away to keep his punches up. Careless with his body shots. Several have gone low, but the referee was unsighted.
That's it, that's the shot I'm talking about. There it is.
Kraus needs to step up his punch rate. That the longer this fight goes, the more it will favor the champion. Well, Cowie has got stronger, not weaker. And some of the snap and some of the spring step, Krause's step. Going round six. Oh, what a awesome right to the head from Cowie. That shook Krause. Even this man of steel can be hurt. Good left hook. A couple of low body shots from Cowie. Boxing from behind the jab, but the damaging blows are coming from the American. Unquestionably. Couple of good jabs from Kraus. Got out of the corner very smartly.
Okay.
Some of the best moments in round six now. Carlius landing the punches that are really painful. In the cross corner, Nas Poortus and
Claude Penny. Fast break. I just saw as he's on. Okay, with a minute there, Drek, me. Let me keep with your rest.
Hang on there, and when you hit him off. Here we go. Well, Krause is certainly hanging on, and he needs to. He takes punches like that. We have Harvey at the point on our card at the start of round seven. Oh, very good uppercut from Krause. And he's beginning to fire some very useful left hands. Bothering fighting. Breaking his rhythm. The American is so occupied with trying to avoid the punches, he's not throwing any of his own. But still, he comes forward. This has become a battle of attrition. Jab is hardly ever out of the American space.
Right there! Put it on the feet for Nolan!
It certainly scores points, but it doesn't keep Harvey from coming forward.
There's one combination, Dwight! There it is! Do it again! Do it again! Get on top and do it again!
American's corner urging Harvey to throw more combinations. His punch rate seems to have fallen away just a little bit now in round seven. Could it be that the challenge is beginning to tire? Krause has taken the challenge's best shots. And it's significant that he hasn't really hurt Harvey with any of the punches he's landed.
Put the hook on the top!
But that jab keeps scoring points. And it was a useful uppercut from Krause, not between the gloves. And more. This is a good round for Krause. A much better round for Krause.
So he got close up.
Carvey's corner, Wesley Bouzon, and cutman Charlie Spicer. No work to be done on his face at the moment, and now the Krause corner again.
Net staardig, weet je, Pieter. Je is net zo goed en sterker als hij in die binnengevechten, hoor. Heb je dit mooi gehoord? Je telt zijn kind baie mooi op en je werkt baie hard daar. Maar nou, eerst voorzichtig dat je daar linkerhand die je vinnig opbrengt van de rechterhand. Dit doorkom met jou, hoor je, Boetman. Oké, okay. Je beweegt baie mooi rechts wanneer je rechts...
Krause is men confirming that he's just as effective at close sport as is the challenger. Well, this is the halfway stage of the fight. Round 8, scheduled for 15. And there is little between the men so far. In many respects, it's become a battle of attrition. mental strength, fitness could be the tiny factor. And now, if Moran warns Kaui to keep his punches up, that was clearly a low blow. The American has landed several this evening.
Come on, Dwight, look, get loose, man! That's the double hook right there! The double hook is right there!
Kraus working away with the jab. And he threw the gloves with those uppercuts. A useful right from Kraus. So that he's beginning to put more power behind his punches. And Kraus is stuck into action. Thank you, sir. Now for the rush again. As usual, Kraus takes him well.
Come on, make a fight out!
Kaui beginning to miss with a right hand. That left jab in his face all the time must be bothering him.
Come on, Dwight!
Besides scoring points. You'll notice that Kraus is now boxing from a distance, from behind the jab. Making use of his longer reach, greater height. That's a very useful body shot from the champion.
Come on, Dwight!
Kraus is boxing methodically, putting his punches together well. Perhaps he lacks the power of Kaui, but he's persistent and consistent. Kraus boxing scientifically and with new confidence now as he sees Kaui's taunting fading away. Kaui's got a lot less time now for fooling around. Challenge the champion. Psychological reinforcement here, champion.
Can you? Huh?
Well, with half the fight over, we've got the boxes even on our scorecard. That's the second half of the fight that will decide the decision.
Come on in, come on in! Come on, come on away with it!
Patton is remaining almost on track, right off the round. Kaui coming in, throwing those punches to the head, left and right. Kraus reclined with the jab, the occasional hook and right cross. Except that in this round, we haven't seen very much in the way of punches from the champion. With a tremendous right, and Kraus is hurt. He is definitely hurt. Now the American comes loose. Kaui pushes his opportunity. And he put it together. Kraus is dazed. Kaui looking for the punch to end the fight. Kraus trying to fight back using the jab. He's in trouble. Desperate trouble. Thank you. he's been called a one shot to end the fight. He has the experience, he knows what to do. And he's picking his punches as Kraus sags into the ropes. How many more of those right hands can he take and stand upright? Even the bravest men will fall eventually. Kraus desperately tries to fight Howie off, using the jab. And surprisingly, the American is allowing to back off. And get out of what is a desperate situation for the champion. Gradually, Kraus is coming out of the fog. Once again, Howie has it backed into a corner. And once again, the right hand has shaken him. Kraus has got his hands at his side. Open to the right hand. This is Howie's best opportunity to win the fight. And Kraus is fighting back. And listen to the crowd roaring on. Dwight Mohammed Howie's round again. So close he came to putting his opponent down in round number 9. There's one. And these punches are dazing the champion. He really was sent back there several times. An impressive, powerful, stunning display by Mohammed Howie.
Er komt terug op zijn achterste voet, Pieter. Oké, dan je de beste van die zaal.
Bobby came close to knocking him out in round 9. The champion has remarkable recuperative powers. Once again, he's back in the fight, boxing from behind the jab, bouncing around on his toes. He needs to win a few rounds, but in his head clear. But most of all, he needs to get more respect from the American, from the challenger. Now he might have missed his best opportunity in round 9. Never knows, he tried to end up there and then. Courageous champion who stood everything he threw at him. And now he's come back to take the play away from the challenger in round 10. Again, Kraus is hurt with a right to the head. And again, Bobby Kraus is against the ropes. Kraus needs to get inside that right hand to pull some steam out of it. He really has little defense against the right hand. And even the left. Kraus has a very good start, beginning to lose ground. Once again. But he exchange. But it's scoring with the right hand. But now it's Kwame who's got Crouch back on the ropes. Wait, he's very little of the opportunity here, there. I reckon they're heading to this badly. Crouch once more in front of the jam. A lot of courage shown by the Krauss here. Got a break. The challenger's spirit is what is being stressed, and Kawi's spirit looks pretty sound. After two-thirds of what could be a 15-round fight. Kawi much quieter, punching heavily. Starts around 11. I reckon he's slightly ahead on points on that card. Krauss will be on the numbers. Coming in clearly just to keep the pressure on. Now on time. And this could be it. Krauss in desperate trouble. Can he survive yet again? Think that there's no power in those punches from Krauss. Just arm movement. Surprisingly, Kawi is not punching back. Now he is. That uppercut shook Krauss. His little strength left in the champion's punches. He's desperate. And this could be the round in which they're going to get injured. About 1 minute 50 into the 11th round, after a dramatic knockdown at about 1:10 in the same round, and after that first knockdown, there was no way that Krauss would come back. As Bert Lewin said, there was no power left in his punches. They were just movements. His arms. Here's the announcement. First knockdown, let's do it again.
Well, that was the knockdown that actually ended the fight. Kraus in trouble. Great fight in the Sun City Super Bowl. A fight filled with action, which a crowd of 7,000 people enjoyed.
Junior heavyweight champion of the WBA, I knocked out in the 11th round, 1 minute 47 seconds, Dwight Muhammad Crowley. Thank you. Thank you.
A new champion crowned in the Super Bowl this evening. And South African former champion, certainly not disgraced. He took a lot of punishment and he came back time and time again until he simply couldn't come back again. The 11th round.
Kraus displayed remarkable courage. Took far too many right hands to the head. If anything, I think it was his lack of defense against the right hand that really lost him this fight this evening. He had no defense against Howie's right hand. And although he took many of the punches well in the early part of the fight, in the end, the accumulative effect was far too great.
There's simply no argument against that sort of performance. Dwight Muhammad Howie has become the new champion. UWBA Junior Heavyweight Champion. And he's done it in 5-star against a champion who won against Ocasio, defended in 5-star against Stevens, but coming up against an almighty puncher this evening.